miss you when I'm gone. Oh, I'm gonna love you now like it's all I have. And I know it'll kill me when it's over. I don't wanna think about it. I want you to love me now. So I'm gonna love you now, like it's all I have. I know it'll kill me when it's over. I don't wanna think about it. I want you to love me now. I don't know who's gonna kiss you when I'm gone. So I'm gonna love you now, like it's all I have. And I know it'll kill me when it's over. I don't wanna think about it. I just wanna love you now.
right, it's that time again. You're listening to Lake Effect Radio here with Nick and Jeremiah. Jeremiah, what's the show called today?
I don't know. I don't know what to call this.
London actually likes the Browns. It seemed that way yesterday, so.
Sorta. Didn't like Kenny Britt for sure.
Oh, no. After the things he said about them?
Yeah. And him in... Did he even make a catch yesterday?
He didn't even play it down yesterday.
Oh, he didn't even play it down?
No, he never entered the game yesterday. We checked after the game, so.
Nah. I was thinking of it, but it's like, I don't want to know. So, yeah.
Did you hear that report a little while ago how Greg Williams warned the Browns about Kenny Britt? But I guess they decided, Greg Williams warned the Browns about bringing in Kenny Britt and his attitude problems, and they still did it anyways. Well, I guess at Hugh's press conference today, he said if he would have known that about Kenny Britt, that he wouldn't be here. And like, you were told, though. Like,
yeah, for my phone.
That was good. That was good.
Well, for one thing is, I'm not surprised. Because he was the Rams' defensive coordinator.
Yes.
So, he probably knew. He probably said it to somebody and they didn't care.
Probably.
So, Kenny Britt, hating on London, all that, didn't really play it down and all that, and the many other things and that. And Mr. Fumblehands. That one's for you, Kenny. That one's for you.
Apparently, my sister tried to get Kenny Britt to block her on Twitter.
Really?
When it was the day, like, he said all the stuff about how he hates London, and my sister tweeted at him, "Don't worry, everyone in Cleveland hates you, too."
God bless.
It didn't work. I told her to keep trying, because that was pretty good.
No, you gotta come up with more things.
Well, yeah. I mean, like I said, keep trying, so...
Like, what's the difference between a rock and Kenny Britt's hands?
There is no difference.
Yeah, at least a rock you can actually catch something.
Well, that is true.
Not too soon?
Not soon enough, if you ask me.
So, yeah, I couldn't help that one.
Mm-hmm. So, did you even bother to watch the game on Sunday?
I listened.
I was traveling down to my buddies, so I listened to, like, the first half on the way down there. They seemed decent in the first half, but then second half, they kind of just went back to the old Browns.
The good old Kaiser-ness.
Yep. Hey, at least he didn't throw an interception.
Why? Because they gave the ball to anyone but him in the end zone. Or down near the end zone.
I saw one of those memes. It was the guy who's, like, pointing at his brain, and it said, "Can't throw an interception if I don't throw in the red zone."
Yeah, did you see they gave it to Crowell? They gave it to anybody. And a few times he threw it, he pretty much didn't even throw it that someone can catch it.
I see, I didn't know that.
In the red zones. Well, I sort of looked over, the recaps. So, he didn't even have a chance to try to throw the football to get picked off. In Kaiser's fashion.
Mm-hmm.
So, Kaiser, just this one's for you.
Yeah, the Kaiser thing hasn't really gone very well so far. So.
No, the Kaiser experiment's been a failure. Failure and a half.
Yeah. So, if you're the Browns, if you have the number one pick, do you take Barkley the running back or do you go quarterback?
You really want to know?
I do want to know.
In Cleveland Brown fashion, we won't have the number one pick. We'll trade back. We're not going to have the opportunity to either pick one of those. But be honest, though, if they actually would stick them with it, I would probably go Barkley.
I'd have to kind of agree with that, so...
You gotta go, let's face it, Crowell's in his final year here.
Mm-hmm.
He's a free agent. He's not really worth it. He's not that elusive and all that. He can pound it. The only thing is he doesn't have the hands He doesn't got the running style.
Right.
Bring in Barkley.
Yeah.
So
I was talking with my buddy last week. Is this rock bottom, or is there still lower that the Browns can go?
You really want to know?
I do want to know, and give me your sound effect, because I know it's coming. Yeah, 0-16 wouldn't surprise me with Thomas out, so.
We haven't reached the all-time low yet. We're going for the perfect season.
More like the imperfect season.
Oh, the perfect season. Making other teams look good compared to our own.
We've been doing that since 99, man.
We had two good years, though, out of it.
Two out of how many?
I know. So, pretty much a recap of, the defense looked there.
Defense seemed pretty good, especially in the first half, when offense was actually doing some things, but second half, when offense went away, defense
still
just got tired. A
little confusion that. But yeah, offense, pretty much looked like a train wreck, like it always has. We don't understand the definition of an offense, so, this is going to be the Browns. When you hear Browns and offense, you're like, you know, so mix. They don't.
Right.
I'm not going to lie. So, yeah, that's pretty much the reality of the Cleveland Browns.
Yeah. Yeah, once again, not looking good. Cavs aren't looking too good either lately.
Well, they just had to gel.
Yeah.
They'll come together.
Mm-hmm.
I'm not worried about them.
I'm not really too worried yet, so.
So. Yeah.
I think it would help if they had actual starting lineup that lasted for more than one game, though, so.
True. They need to develop a rhythm. But yeah, the more less depressing news would be the Cavs. But yeah.
Mm-hmm.
They gotta develop a rhythm. He's gotta find the pieces. But it'll come. I'm not worried about it.
Right. I guess Lou said some of the new players are intimidated to play with LeBron, so.
I could see it. They all gotta find their place and keys and that. So, they'll come together. It's just a matter of time until everyone gets together, gets their thing and that going and all that. So,
mm-hmm.
I'm not really worried about it. They'll get it.
Mm-hmm.
Cavs will be the Cavs. They'll come out.
Yeah.
They'll start kicking butt. End.
One positive, Golden State isn't doing too well either so far.
I know. You might want to tell Kyle.
Oh, that's right. He is a Golden State fanboy, isn't he?
Saturday when we're in the middle of Buffalo Wild Wings, he goes and says, well, the Cavs lost by 21 points. And how early in the season is this? Exactly.
It's October, so.
So, am I really worried? No. Do I really care? No. I'm going to throw him under the bus just for that sake. For one. Two is him bringing up that Ohio State won by a point.
True. That was probably the game of the year so far.
Pretty much.
And it lived up to the hype. I mean, it looked like Ohio State was done, but they came back big time.
Since I got stuck going to hay rides and that.
Ah, okay.
The only time I seen was at halftime that they were down by 15.
Mm-hmm.
Then at the one probably after it was over, and that I seen they won by a point.
Yeah.
But I got to watch it, though, last night. At least the second half of it, they had a replay of it going.
Oh, okay, cool.
It lived up to the thing. Compared to Michigan just barely squeaking past, like, was it Indiana or whatever?
Yeah, Michigan's not doing well.
Did they just barely squeak past them in that?
Mm-hmm.
The win by 1 point, that was the game of you would expect it compared to Michigan just barely squeaking past Indiana.
Right. Yeah, I remember Saturday.
Syracuse losing, or Clemson losing to Syracuse.
Mm-hmm. If I remember Saturday night, we were going out for my mom's birthday, and we went down to the flats to the new Margaritaville, and we were lucky enough to catch, like, the fourth quarter of Ohio State there, so that was fun. So, place was hopping for the game.
At the hayrides, you want to, especially because one of the sites, they have the Minion, and they have Neon Sloopy going in that, because they refer to Minion University.
Mm-hmm.
You wouldn't seem out of all those people in that when you went past there, they weren't even excited one bit.
I see.
Of it. You would think, oh, you know, they would be excited in that. No. It was like pulling teeth.
I see.
So, yeah.
Mm-hmm.
I finally, at some point in time, like 8:30 or something, was able to go and check my phone to see the score in that scene.
Gotcha.
So, good for them, though.
Mm-hmm.
I just say one thing, Ohio State showed their offense. Over 500 something yards.
They did. My boy JT lit it up on Saturday.
He did light it up.
Mm-hmm.
Especially the double coverage or triple coverage throws that he put in. That was hilariously, like, stringing the line.
Right.
So, I'll give it to him.
Mm-hmm.
If he wasn't in the Heisman and that, people were considering him, he should be after that one.
Right.
Because he looked like a pro.
Mm-hmm.
I'll give it to him. Then especially over the 200 yards on the ground that they did. They pretty much annihilated Penn State.
Yeah, I mean, if it wasn't for their miscues in the first half, that game would have easily been Ohio State's instead of going right down to the wire.
True. I'll give it that. The second half, that late pitch and that, from looking at the box score, the fumble by, was it Harris?
Campbell? I think so.
From what it said in that, I don't know how he got hit in that, but yeah.
Mm-hmm.
It would show, if that didn't happen in there, it probably wouldn't be the outcome that we seen.
No, it definitely wouldn't have.
So, but now I have some gloating to do. Wednesday morning for Scott and Steve.
Ah, there you go.
Even though they'll say, oh, well, they just barely won by 1 point. It doesn't matter. They won.
Right.
Oklahoma's going to go down. It's all doesn't matter.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, Oklahoma losing to Oklahoma State this week, and there you go.
Yep.
So it'll be
the Brandon Whedon fanboy in you would be very happy.
I hated Whedon.
I know, that's why I said it.
I hated him before the draft, and I hated him even more when we actually drafted him.
You and I were in the same boat.
So, that was a poor decision.
One of many.
Decisions.
One of many.
Can we figure out the most poor decision that we ever had?
I think it's close between either taking a 28-year-old rookie quarterback in the first round or Johnny.
Well, Richardson's up there.
Oh, that's true. They traded up a spot for Richardson.
He's up there.
There was also Gilbert.
And Quinn.
True.
Let's see. Let's actually figure this one out.
What, you looking up, like, the worst Browns moves or something?
No, I'm going draft picks first before going okay. to the Browns.
Want to hear a sad tweet yesterday about the Browns?
Okay.
Yesterday, Daryl Ryder from 92.3 The Fan put this. Carson Wentz, 7 wins, MVP candidate. Deshaun Watson, 4 touchdown passes today, recording record book or rewriting record books. Then Deshaun Kizer wasn't benched. That's the highlight of Deshaun Kizer.
Yeah, that's kind of sad.
Mm-hmm. Now, last night I was on Facebook just scrolling, and NFL posted a video, Deshaun Kizer highlights of the game in London. I'm like, what highlights is there to show of him? He didn't score other than the rushing touchdown, but passing he did nothing.
Yeah, this is true.
Still trying to find it, Jay?
Yeah, I'm trying to find all the selections. Wait, here we go.
Okay, let's have it.
Ah, I don't want all those. I just want the Browns. It was showing me all the picks. Which I don't want.
Are you just trying all Browns draft picks or just Browns first round?
All Browns first round. Why not?
Okay. This is going to be a very sad discussion here.
Oh, God, yes. Everyone knows this. You just think of how many bad draft picks we had.
How far back we going?
From the beginning. You gotta go all the ways back from the beginning.
Very, very beginning?
Yes, the very beginning in 1999.
Oh, I thought you were talking about, like, old Browns, so.
Okay, here we go. This, so, got Couch.
Over Donovan McNabb, remember that.
Yeah. Good or bad?
He did have some good moments and some bad moments, but the fact that they pass on McNabb for him, I give it a thumbs down.
Courtney Brown.
Who did we take him over? Let me see here. And was that the year they could have had LT?
Probably. It wouldn't be surprising there.
I think that might have been the year after, but the Browns did pass up on Jamal Lewis. Could have been a running back, Thomas Jones, but yeah, I'm going to just give that a thumbs down.
Mr. Warren.
Oh, huge thumbs down. Huge thumbs down.
William Green.
Another thumbs down. That didn't really work out.
Jeff Bain.
He played all right for the Browns, and then he ended up leaving when his contract was up. I'll give that a thumbs up one.
Kel Winslow.
Thumbs down. Huge thumbs down. Mr. Injury Prone, and then he had the one season and thought he was Mr. All High and Mighty.
Brandon
Edwards. Braylon Edwards. Oh, thumbs down. Mr. Butterfingers.
Wimley.
That's an interesting one. He never played really that bad, but never as good as his potential showed. I'll give it a slight thumbs down.
Joe Thomas.
Oh, the biggest thumbs up.
You know who I'm going
Joe
to say?
Joe Thomas is like the number one person on the Browns Rushmore since 99.
Quinn.
Thumbs down. He was a bust.
2018, we did not, or 2008, we did not have a first
round. That's right, because we traded the first round pick to Dallas to get Brady Quinn, but the Browns went 10-6 that year, so it wouldn't have been a high pick anyways.
Alex Mack.
Thumbs up.
Joe Hayden.
As much as I disliked him and thought he was overrated, thumbs up.
Phil Taylor.
I kind of feel like he's in the same boat as Wimbley here, so I'm going to give him a slight thumbs down.
Trent Richardson.
Oh, huge thumbs down.
Whedon.
I'm really starting to get depressed now because we're getting to these guys. Huge thumbs down.
Mingo.
Huge thumbs down.
That one.
It works.
Okay, cool. What's up, Bossman?
Justin Gilbert.
Huge thumbs down.
Johnny Manziel, as much as it pains me to say.
Huge thumbs down. I'm getting really depressed now.
Terrence West, who we traded, and now he's good.
No.
He's not that good.
This is just first round picks.
Oh.
So, Sheldon.
By the way, it's 420.
Sheldon, good. Last year he was pretty good.
Danny Shelton.
Last year
he
was pretty
good.
He's been struggling with injuries this year. I'll give him a thumbs up.
All right.
Cam Irving.
Geez. Bye. He's on Chiefs now. He's blocking for Kareem Hunt.
I'll just say this about Cam Irving. We won that trade because we actually got a 7th round pick for Cam Irving.
Well, he's actually doing pretty decent.
I don't care. I watched him get turned around in a preseason game. He didn't touch anyone. I was happy when he was gone.
Thumbs up.
I'll give it a slight thumbs up.
I mean, he's going to be one of our main wideouts.
I'm neutral.
I say slight.
Yeah, I agree with that.
He's got the potential, but he's just so injury prone.
DeShone Kizer.
Thumbs down.
Garnett. Miles Garrett.
Oh, Garrett, thumbs up.
Thumbs up. All right, I'm out.
Peppers.
Thumbs down.
David Njoku.
I'll give him a thumbs up. Matt Bossman, what has Peppers done this year? You could have had Malik Hooker.
Main kick returner. If we could block for him, he'd be good, just like Kizer.
No, Kizer's trash. He is trash.
The fact that we passed up on Malik Hooker and end up getting Peppers is a huge mistake by the front office.
But then Hooker's out for the year.
Yeah, but at least he's gotten some. He got like 3 picks already before the injury. Peppers has done nothing.
Very true. Yeah, that's your disappointment first round draft picks.
Yep.
Since 1999. But then the hilarious thing is I'm seeing here and I'm looking at all the different draft picks along that you got, like in 99, you have Kevin Johnson, you have McCutcheon.
I was a big Dale McCutcheon fan as a kid.
You know, you got Shade, that wasn't horrible, except he had injury issues later in his years here. You have Sanders, DB, not that bad. Northcutt. Then you have the one guard that was a 7th round pick. Paul
Zukauskas?
Yeah.
I remember meeting him. He was one of the nicest Browns players I ever met.
Anthony Henry.
I liked Anthony Henry.
James Jackson.
Was never big on James Jackson.
He was a good 3rd round, or down back.
Yeah, overall, I guess you could say that.
Quincy Morgan?
He was okay.
Yeah. Andre Davis?
Another okay guy.
Melvin Flowers?
Melvin Flowers?
He
Melvin
was a
Fowler?
Center.
I remember his name. I don't remember watching him play that much, so.
He was a backup, then he ended up as a center and that.
Okay.
He wasn't that bad.
All right, I'll take your word for it.
Kevin Brantley.
Kevin Bentley?
Or Bentley.
I want to say he was all right, if my memory serves me correctly.
Ben Taylor,
I was kind of on.
Andre Davis
was all right.
And you know the funny thing is, he was 5th round pick.
Really?
Yeah, from what it says right here.
Wow, I never would have thought that.
Then you have Fain. Thompson. Suggs
was alright. I always liked Lee Suggs.
Chris Crocker.
He was a decent defensive back. Yeah.
Then the first long snapper that was here for years, and that Ryan Poorman.
Foreman?
He had a long snapper. They threw him out.
You mean Pontrebrand?
Or Pontrebrand, yeah.
Yeah, I liked him a lot. He got released unfairly. Because there was, like, the one thing with Alec the snap hit Alex Mack's leg, and it was Mack's fault, but he took the blame. Leg. And then, because of all the criticism, he missed one the next week and then got cut. So. Yeah.
Then you have Sean Jones.
I liked Sean Jones. He kind of struggled with injuries, especially his rookie year. But other than that, I thought he was all right.
You know, Luke McCown, he wasn't the most greatest.
No, I remember being a really big fan of his as a kid, but he really wasn't that special.
That's no one that much special out of 2004 class. Then Brodney Pohl. He was a good one there.
Yeah, he was all right.
Let's see. 2006 class, that's where it was. Of Jackson.
Oh, DeQuell?
Yeah, DeQuell.
I loved DeQuell. I was such a big fan of his. I was so sad when we released him.
Leon Williams?
Eh.
Yeah, Jerome Harrison. He wasn't the most greatest running back.
Hey, he was pretty good when he was with the Browns.
Then you have Vickers.
Vickers was awesome, an awesome fullback.
Sixth round pick.
That was a gem by the Browns.
That was the best one out of that. Then you had seven. You have Thomas. Eric Wright.
Eric Wright was very mixed bag. He started off good, but after that first couple years, he was really bad.
Brandon McDonald.
He was a mixed bag also. His rookie year, he played decent, but I want to say after that, he struggled a bit. I could be wrong on that, though.
Then you had the short draft class.
2008?
Yeah.
That was a really bad draft class for the Browns.
Except Ruben, which he was a six.
I forgot about Ruben.
He was a six.
I was a really big fan of Ruben.
And Alex Hall. He was a seven.
Alex Hall. I don't remember Alex Hall.
He came in mid-season there in the tail end. He wasn't that bad.
Oh, okay. Once again, I'll take your word for it.
Yeah, Brian Robisky, Mesqua, they were jokes.
Yeah, they were bad.
But though, David and what was it? Besides Mac in that class.
Was it, you should have taken Matthews in that draft.
Mayava or whatever? The
Mayava, trash. They should have taken Matthews in the first round. I can't believe. Out of the three USC linebackers, we got the worst one of them.
You know the worst thing is? We had a first round pick in 3 seconds that year.
Mm-hmm, because we kept trading back.
Yeah.
Should have taken Matthews.
Well, the one class that it started off really decent, at least, you had Hayden. Ward.
Mm-hmm.
Go ahead and forget about the running back in between there.
The running back. Which?
From Tennessee. Mr. Injury Pro.
Oh, I know you're. Yeah, let's not bring him up.
Colt McCoy. Which?
My boy.
That could have been if he had actually pieces around
if
him.
If he would have had time. Two things, time and an offensive line and receivers to throw to.
Sean LaValle.
LaValle. Oh, offensive lineman, right?
And you know the funny thing is? He's playing as a starter in dear old Washington.
You see, I never thought he was that bad for the Browns, so.
Yeah. That year was some four good picks, especially LaValle being a third round. Yeah, Taylor, Serve Bus, Little. Yeah, we don't want to talk about.
Oh, gosh, Greg Little.
Sheard was. He's still playing, and he's looking actually not that bad.
You see, I was never a big fan of him with the Browns, mainly because when we lined him up at defensive line, he would always jump off sides. But it seems like he's been doing pretty well with New England, so.
Buster Screen.
You see, I liked Screen. I know everyone hated Screen, but I thought after his rookie year, he was pretty decent for us.
Really was sort of the tail end of his second into his third.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I'd agree with that.
Jason Pinkston. Pinkston. He was a good one.
He was a good one. I think his career got short due to like health issues.
Yeah. Then, yeah, 2012. Let's face it, the first two were bust.
Yeah.
But, yeah, Michael Schwartz.
Mitchell Schwartz,
whatever.
Should have never let him walk.
John Hugh, he was sort of decent.
Yeah, but we reached for him big time.
Yeah. Travis Benjamin, he was a dangerous dude.
It was all right. His last year with the Browns, he played pretty good.
Yeah. But after that, he hasn't.
Yeah, I don't think he's really done that much with the Chargers.
Except he had a punt return like 2 weeks ago.
Oh, did he?
Yeah, for a touchdown. Billy Winn, he had his
You see, time. I always liked Billy Winn. High motor guy from Boise State. You don't think about those kind of guys coming out of Boise State.
2013, you can't even talk about anyone there. That was somewhat a joke class. Then you go 14. You have Antonio. Kirksey. West, he's sort of had his light pulled in Baltimore. Then you have Pierre Desir? Yeah. He hasn't been really much of anything.
No, not really.
Then you have, was it Orchard? I don't really like that they're bright. He's more a linebacker than a defensive lineman.
Right.
Duke.
I like Duke.
Cooper, which I think's no longer with the team.
No, he's not.
Campbell, the safety, he's there. Which he's sort of pulling together. Still, he has some learning in that to do.
Do we still have Campbell?
He's gone. Gainsey's gone. Randall Typher, whatever his name. Or Telfer.
Yeah, Telfer.
It's not really. He's more of a blocking guy.
Right.
Then 2016. So let's see. Go backwards from Higgins. He needs to develop more.
Right.
Spencer. He could be a tackle.
I feel like he's more of a guard than a tackle.
He's sort of putting it together, especially filling in for Thomas.
Yeah, I guess that's true. I heard he played decent on Sunday. I know when he came in for Thomas the week before, he really struggled.
Well, he didn't expect that.
Well, that is true.
And plus, he was playing more with probably second stringer / more scout team the week before.
True.
So, Seth, which I didn't realize, he was a tight end.
Seth DeValve?
He was a wide receiver.
Oh, he was.
Originally.
Oh, I never knew that.
My bad. Yeah, he was a wide receiver all along in the first place.
Interesting.
So he developed, which I can live with that.
Mm-hmm.
What do you think of Derek?
Derek Kindred?
Yeah.
Nothing. I don't think he's anything too special.
Lewis.
Ricardo Lewis?
Yep.
Decent. Nothing great, but for the Browns, it's like, hey, someone okay to throw to.
Joe Sherbert?
I like Sherbert. I think he's been playing pretty well so far.
You know, this year. Thing is?
Huh.
He was an outside linebacker.
Oh, and they've got him at middle now, don't they?
Yeah.
Interesting.
Cody?
They reached big time for Kessler. Although, I've kind of been like, I think the Browns should go with Cody Kessler for the rest of the season. But yeah, they reached at him. No reason to take him in the third round.
Coleman?
thumbs up. Like I said, he's got good potential, but I'm very concerned about him being injury prone.
Carl?
Nassib?
Yep.
Decent. I still think he needs to develop more, but decent.
Then you know the other one. What would you say?
I'm trying to think. Who do we...
Emmanuel?
Oh, that's right. Ogba. Ogba got potential there, so...
And Days.
I heard he had a really good training camp, so who knows? He might be decent.
They used him as kick returner, which that was somewhat a joke.
Ah, okay.
Gonzalez.
He's hit his up and downs this year. My dad wants a different kicker, but I mean, he's just a rookie, and he did hit a 54-yarder, so he's got no leg on him.
Brantley.
Incomplete, because we haven't seen too much of him, but I'm going to give him a slight thumbs up, because he has looked decent, so.
Yeah, Johnson, he hasn't played.
No.
Wilson hasn't played. Larry?
Larry Ogunjobi?
Yep.
He could be okay. Like, I think he's another guy who needs to develop some more.
Kaiser?
Not a fan so far. I'll give him a thumbs down.
There you go. That's your whole since 1999.
Alrighty. Well, I say we take a little music break and we'll be right back here on Lake Effect Radio.
Love me like you love me when you love me and you didn't know. knows how to get her on my back. I wanted to carry a football. That dream came and went real soon. Made it through 2 years of college. Thank God I could carry her too. Nah, nah, yeah. Thank God I could carry her too. I'm no love, I'm no pain. Got a little rusty in the rain. I've been lost, I've been found. I left my mark on a little bitty town. Yeah, raise me a few good babies. Raise me a whole lot of hell. And if I ever get to heaven, I'm gonna have a story to tell. Yeah, if I get there, I'm gonna have a story to tell. Cheap whiskey, shut down too many bars. Low as a dog in the valley and high as the Carolina stars. I've kissed some girls, still miss some girls, most beautiful you've ever seen. I gave my heart to a woman who didn't give a damn about me. I'm no love, I'm no pain. Got a little rusty in the rain. I've been I left my mark on my little bitty town. Yeah, raise me a few good babies. Raise me a whole lot of hell. And if I ever get to heaven, I'm gonna have a story to tell. Yeah, if I get there, I'm gonna have a story to tell. It's got some parts that'll make you laugh and some that'll make you cry. Some pages I wish I could tear out, but I ain't gonna tell no lie, 'cause it's the story of my life. Now I can't preach or give no advice. I didn't do everything well, but man, just live while you're alive and try to have a story to tell. I'm no love, I'm no pain. I got a little rusty in the ring. Y'all, I've been lost, I've been found. I left my mark on my little bitty town. I'll raise me a few good babies. I'll raise me a whole lot of hell. And if I ever get to heaven, I'm gonna have a story to tell. Yeah, if I get there, I'll have a real good story to tell. Nah, nah, yeah, we'll have a real good story to tell.
All right, you listen to Kiss Tomorrow Goodbye by Luke Bryan and Story to Tell by the Darius Rucker.
I have a story to tell.
What's your story?
Well, Matt Bosman that just got burnt and was even around to hear it. True story. I write a novel. It'll last longer.
There we go. I like novels.
So, yeah. Yeah, let's not talk about Cleveland sports and that anymore.
Yeah, what else you want to talk about today, Jay?
How Ohio State's going to pretty much prove everyone wrong now.
I think this could be a repeat of their national championship season, mm-hmm. where after they lost to Virginia Tech and come back to win out.
Pretty much.
Could happen. It feels that way this year.
You knew they were going to gain it together and that.
Right.
So, especially with the rain that was earlier in the day Saturday, and that probably didn't help too with the miscues and that.
Right.
But, I'm not that worried.
Mm-hmm.
Let's see the rankings and that.
Top 25 rankings today. I know Ohio State's 3.
Yep. Georgia, number 2.
Mm-hmm. Alabama, 1. Wisconsin's 4?
Yep. Notre Dame, Clemson, Penn, Oklahoma, Miami, TCU.
Yeah, TCU ended up losing. That was a big loss.
You knew it was a matter of time.
Right.
Like I said, this year, if you're in the top 25, you're not safe.
No, definitely not.
You're not 100%.
And it's really one of the things that makes college football so fun.
Like you have, what is it, from 11 down, Oklahoma State, Washington, Virginia, Iowa State, number 14.
Wow, who would have thunk it?
UCF, Auburn, and USC, number 17. I had to say that one. I had to make sure it stung for Kyle.
There we go.
Stanford, LSU, North Carolina State, is that Mississippi State, Memphis, Arizona, Michigan State, and Washington University. So, yeah.
I see. Like I said, the fact that no one's safe is just why college football is so much fun.
A hilarious thing is the coaches poll. Notre Dame's not listed as high.
Oh.
Miami's up higher. Oklahoma's at 9. It's kind of funny.
Mm-hmm.
Michigan's in the top 25? They actually threw Michigan State off. Yeah, coaches poll is interesting. It really messes with like the last like 15 down, last 10.
Yeah.
It really, really messes with everything. Especially USF being on the list.
Yeah, that's true.
That's interesting. I give it to them. Let's see. Who's this week's fun?
What's going on?
Looking at this upcoming week.
Upcoming games? Let's find out here. Is Ohio State playing this weekend? Yeah. I think they are. Because they just had a bye week the other week, so.
Oh, USC versus Arizona.
I'm going to take Arizona in this one.
Yeah. Hatred for Kyle's team goes a lot farther. Really, I don't have that much hatred. I just want to see USC lose.
Right.
Washington, Oregon.
I'm going to say Washington.
Miami, Virginia. Tech.
I'm going to have to go with Miami. As much as I like Virginia Tech, I'm going to go with Miami.
LSU, Bama.
Bama.
So TCU versus Texas.
You know who I'm going to pick. You already know.
Yeah.
I'm a homer. Texas.
Oklahoma State.
State.
Yeah, you gotta go State. So I just want to see Oklahoma fall down again.
Right.
Stanford, Washington State.
Stanford.
Iowa State versus West Virginia.
I'm gonna go Iowa State.
Clemson, North Carolina State.
That's gonna be a good game.
I know.
And I'm gonna go North Carolina State on this one.
Yeah, I got to. In Notre Dame Wake, you probably realize they're going to roll.
Mm-hmm.
Ohio State, Iowa.
Ohio State.
Georgia versus South Carolina.
I'm going to take the upset here. South Carolina.
Okay. Wisconsin, Indiana.
Wisconsin.
Penn versus Michigan State.
That should be a good game.
That kicks off at noon.
I think I'm going to have to go Penn on this one.
Auburn, Texas A&M.
Auburn.
Let's see. Massachusetts versus Mississippi State.
Mississippi State.
Memphis and TLSA.
Memphis and Tulsa. I don't really know. I guess Tulsa.
That's your Friday night game. Well, why not? It's worth it. Oh, wow, they have some cheap tickets.
Cheaper than the Browns? No, not as cheap as the Browns.
$10?
Not as cheap as the Browns.
What are Browns tickets?
A couple weeks ago, they were going for like $6.
Actually, I just found one. Mississippi State, Massachusetts, $2.
Oh, wow, someone is cheaper.
So, was it Kansas and Baylor? It's $3. This is actually kind of funny. I didn't realize you could see the tickets.
Cool.
Ticket prices, that's actually kind of funny.
Mm-hmm.
Let's see, how much is Ohio State's going for?
Probably quite a bit.
662. That's not bad.
62 a piece?
44 for Penn State's. Let's see, the Oklahoma's. $163.
For Oklahoma?
Yeah, the Oklahoma game.
Overrated. Overpriced.
Yeah, even though it's at State's house, but still, yeah. $163. It's 1,000 and 200 left.
Jeez.
And Matt Bosman is still softer than Cristiano.
There we go.
I couldn't help that.
I don't really blame you.
Especially since he walked past.
Mm-hmm.
But yeah. That's pretty much everything in a nutshell today.
Gotcha.
That's all she wrote, folks.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, we're running out of time. Real quickly, I want to remember how I kept telling you I was going to get my buddy to watch the original Star Wars?
Yeah.
We did it last night, and he said he enjoyed it a lot, and he can't wait to see what happens next. So, next time I go down, we're doing Empire Strikes Back.
Eyes.
No, we really are.
Eyes.
Shut up.
Don't tell me I love my life.
I already did.
Yeah, that's true. I give it to you.
Mm-hmm.
I give it to you.
All right, so I figure just cut the music for the rest of the time, and
yeah.
We'll catch you Wednesday, folks. I've been Nick. That's been
Cristiano.
There we go. And you've been listening to Lake Effect Radio.
Sweat and the heart. been together 58 years now. Ain't that crazy? Kick back and watch bikes race around the track. I'm white knuckled to the handlebars with both my hands. No, I ain't one to just stand around while a parachute falls to the ground. I gotta be hanging underneath it when it lands. I'm not a wonder what it feels like kind of man. Daredevil rebel gene pushes me a little past extreme. I felt it ever since I was a little kid. I ain't gonna get to my rocking chair scratching a head full of silver hair and look back on a bunch of things I wished I did. I'm gonna meet my maker with an empty bucket list. I wanna ski.
Talking all night about a minute.